Welcome to a crash course for pediatric feeding. I have had a ton of requests for this course, and I'm glad that you can be here for it, take it, watch it, whatever. This class is also known as the, oh my God, I've got a feeding kid course, except that Asha is not as happy with that particular title as they are with a crash course for pediatric feeding. We're going to break this down into the first half will be assessment, and then the second half will be treatment. And I'm going to give you the scaffolding. So if you know nothing about pediatric feeding, this is your place to start. If you know some about pediatric feeding, but you're still trying to organize stuff in your head, this is the course for you. If you have done this for decades, and you just need CEUs, this is the course for you. You might learn something new. I learn new things all the time from other instructors. The first thing you want to get when you're going to see a feeding kid is the background information. I want you to write this phrase down. In my pediatric feeding the big picture course, I give bumper stickers. I'm not going to give bumper stickers here during this course, but I'm going to give you highlights that I want to make sure you write. And now studies show that you remember it better if you write it, not type it, but write it. And what I want you to write down right now is you should take a good enough history that you should know what you're going to find. Now, every now and then we might get surprised by something, but that should be less than 10% of the time. You should be asking the right questions. Okay, Jen, what kind of questions? Glad you asked. So what I do first, is I will write down the referring complaint. Then I'll go over the medical history, then the oral motor history, and I will also look at their developmental status. So let's go into those.